Pat McCormick.
Thank you, Milton.
Welcome.
Milton is amazing. He remembers jokes, he remembers things from 50 years ago, and that's because he has these memory tricks. Milton, this is true. Tied a knot in his cock so he wouldn't forget John Holmes' funeral. Took Johnny Francis 3.5 hours to get it out. I think it's kind of charming that Arnold has this space between his front teeth, so wide Milton could stick his cock between them. At least that's what Milton told me. But what a luxury it must be to have a big cock. As Milton sits here right now, he's being jacked off by a Puerto Rican in the kitchen. I guess I've been chosen to go first so that I can set the tone for this evening. This is our man, Arnold Schwarzenegger. To me, Arnold looks like a large condom filled with walnuts. Even as a fetus, Arnold knew he'd be a weightlifter. He bench-pressed his mother's bowels. I found out why Arnold married Maria Shriver. Because she removed a thorn from his paw. Arnold was discovered in a Vienna whorehouse by Jimmy Swaggart. It was Arnold's first contact with religion. Jimmy made Arnold suck on a Bible. Arnold won't say what Jimmy does in those whorehouses with the prostitutes. All we know is it involves Canadian bacon and a horse harness. What kind of a guy is Arnold? Well, as we sit here, in his wallet he has the exact cock measurements of every member of the Vienna Boys Choir. Now, regarding the accusations about fellow Austrian Kurt Waldheim, Arnold said, "I never would have blown him if I knew he was a Nazi." It's actually difficult to find a flaw in Arnold's character, except for that one time outside of Munich when he was caught butt-fucking a rhinoceros. No one would have known except from the screams from the rhinoceros woke half up the village. Half up the village, it's another fucked up thing I said. Arnold is so tough he had to have 4 vasectomies. And the rhinoceros still got pregnant, from what I understand. His body is like steel. Remember in one movie they played the Bells of St. Mary's on his balls. Arnold can be naive. I read that at one time he thought steroids are what you get when you sit on your record player. The steroids made Arnold's cock so small he could fuck a Cheerio. Arnold's a busy man. He once fucked Joan Crawford while she was beating her daughter. How about this? I'm skipping this one for bad taste. Is Arnold creative? Listen to the Valentine he sent Maria last month. How do I love you? Let me count the holes. Cute. Is he strange? Well, in college, he wrote a thesis on this subject. Do pigs close their eyes when they fuck? I call it strange. You can tell a man by his friends. In John Holmes's will, he stipulated that his body be buried in Forest Lawn and his cock be buried in Arnold's ass. Now we get rough. Oh. Is Arnold a kind man? He's the only guy to have fucked Mrs. Gary Hart. Arnold and Danny DeVito, sitting right over here, are doing a movie together. In the movie, Danny plays Arnold's suppository. And Danny, by the way, is doing a sequel to his last movie. He's doing it with footballer Jimmy Brown. It's called Throw Motherfucker from the Train. Arnold, with all his blockbuster movies, he did The Predator, The Terminator, and next he's doing The Exterminator. In it, he goes to the slums, puts cheese on his ass, and snaps off rat heads in his rectum. Cute, huh? Last time I take a joke from Margaret Thatcher. Arnold, congratulations on your success, and my hat and my pants are off to you.
Wonderful. Boy, he's way out, isn't he? I want to tell you, you Irish and we Jews have comedy all wrapped up. I mean it. You've got Eddie Murphy, we got Whoopi Goldberg.